Just pretend like no one's watching.
What is this?
Curveball.
Red Dead?
No.
Graphics look crazy on this game.
Yeah, bro. Crazy.
Realistic rocks, my boy.
Oh, rocks. Oh, fucking rage. Love it.
Oh, I
don't
know.
No, it's too modern.
No. I don't think it's Rage.
What is this?
Yeah, what is this?
Far Cry Primal 2.
I'm so nervous.
No. It couldn't be. Africa couldn't 2. Be Far Cry.
Oh, hang on. They're Halo Marines.
Oh! Iconic!
Halo Marines.
There they are. There we go.
They're...
Iconic here. Oh!
Bruh.
Oh! Bruh!
What?
So iconic! Oh my god! Oh, Larry is crying! Oh.
Stop it. Get some help.
So, let's get ourselves onto the first comment. So, Mr. Dylan Meadows made an extremely fair comment where he said he just wanted to throw his opinion into the mix, as he says, that he did think that their live stream was sincere and the discussions regarding Halo Infinite, which is fine. I think it's sincere as well. But he's right to say that he's cautious about 343 and how they handle the franchise, and he doesn't like when they have rehearsed performances with no sincerity, so he's going to give them the benefit of the doubt until they prove otherwise, which they have in the past, but look, that's his prerogative. So we get the abstract chicken here, which you are a chicken with your 11-inch arms, and yeah, but you guys know what I'm on about here. Someone's saying he totally agrees with your opinion, which I agree with his opinion as well, with Dylan's opinion. Let's just take a step back and wait until we see some details. The only problem with Roni Boni is he completely hates on 343. Not true. He doesn't have to like them. I don't. But he goes off on them way too much. I don't go off on them way too much. Master Chief Collection took 4 years to fix. Nothing. I didn't go off on them enough. I did not go off on them enough. He doesn't hate them. I don't hate 343 either. I don't hate a gaming company, okay? I dislike what they have done with my favorite franchise and with a lot of people's favorite franchise. A franchise that had such potential to be a giant, to continue on as the giant in the console FPS industry. I think that their, you know, my ill feelings towards them are totally warranted. So, you know, I just don't think that this is a good comment from Abstract Chicken, but I don't think he's... I don't think we're going to class him in a completely 343 targeted scenario here, because a lot of people have this opinion towards the criticism that is brought towards Halo and the developers. And that's okay. So I just want to say, Abstract Chicken, if you ever do watch this video, I don't hate on 343. I have satired them, and just because I add memes and things like that doesn't mean I completely hate them. I just think it's funny, and it helps bring people into the video. And I think I also mirror a lot of the sentiments of people in this community. So I don't think that it's an unfair opinion to think that 343 have to keep proving themselves, and that my videos are constructive criticism, and they are going to be, especially going forward. But I just think that this is a bit of a silly comment, but we'll let you away with it this time. Just this time, because we're starting the video. That's why. Okay, next point. So, as for comment 2, I like this one. This is on my video where I said that COD and Halo are kind of synonymous at this point. That COD copied from Halo back in the day. If we look at Halo 2, Halo 2 was the first game to really bring in the rechargeable energy shields. The two-weapon system was first brought in Halo CE. So we know that a lot of first-person shooters in general have copied from Halo. So in this video where I said, will Halo copy COD again for its next title? Because Halo has been taking facets from other games for years. If you look at hit markers, if you look at grenade indicators, if you look at callouts, if you look at the Spartan abilities, a lot of them were even directly quoted as being taken from Destiny as good ideas. If you look at thruster packs, sprint, things like that, Halo has been copying from other games for years. So this guy here, Jeremy Spaulding, who is, his profile is Dewey from Malcolm in the Middle. So he said, dude, you wouldn't be happy if Happy hit you in the face. And bro, they even apologized for not talking to the fans and keeping us in the loop. So they apologized after 4 years. So I don't have to accept an apology that's 4 years too late. Okay, I don't have to accept that apology because at this point in time, I still think that the Master Chief Collection getting its patch was a way for them to try and damage control. They knew that no one was playing Halo 5. They knew that people just wanted the classic Halo experience, so they helped fix the MCC. Am I glad that the MCC is fixed and has a server browser? Well, basically a server browser now for matchmaking. I am. And the campaign theater mode that just came in recently. I am happy that these things have come to the game. I play very little MCC anymore now. One, because I did sell my Xbox, but I do use my brother's Xbox sometimes to get on and play some Halo because it is my favorite franchise of games. Despite all the controversy surrounding the games, I still love Halo. Okay, and I can't get it out of me. I really can't. I've tried. God damn it, I've tried. But I really can't. So I said to this guy, come over here and slap me with some happiness, bro. So I just, these type of comments I get all the time, that if you have any kind of disagreement with somebody in regards to a game developer, well, then you're just not a happy person, which is crazy. I'm a very happy person. I really enjoy my life. The little snapshot that you guys get to see of mine and other YouTubers' lives is totally different, unless they're a vlogger. It's totally different to how we actually live our lives and how we interact with people, friends, family, etc. So I'm happy as fuck, dude. So don't worry about me. Don't worry about me. Worry about Halo. Worry about making Halo the best Halo that you can make it. Because if Halo Infinite is not the best Halo that it can be, neither you or I is going to be happy. And we're both going to need to get slapped in the face by Happy, aren't we? So that comment there was totally 343 tarded. So let's get on to the next one. So this comment here is, it's actually a good point. And I want to, because clearly this guy believes that I'm complaining for the sake of complaining, which is not true. So I want to touch on this point and show the types of opinions that some people can hold towards other members of the Halo community, especially the more vocal ones that criticize 343. So it's laughable that so many complain under the guise of them wanting to make Halo better and get 343 to become better. Yet, when 343 actually does try, those same people have to assume there are alternative motives involved. If you can't even give them the benefit of the doubt when they do something you probably have thought they would never do, then what point do you have sticking around and complaining? You either complain in the hopes of bettering 343 in Halo, or you complain for the sake of complaining. Which is it? So, this is a good point, though. This is a really good point, because there is a lot of confusion in the community between people that are bringing constructive criticism with emotion behind it, and people that are just toxic and salty. And I don't like using those words too much anymore, because they've been totally just... those words are not good words to use anymore because of people throwing them around with, you know, identity politics and things like that these days. So toxic and salty, I don't think are the right things to say. But people that are constructively criticizing Halo, I think, have a big place in the Halo community. Because, as we know, Halo's been run through the dirt. It has been run through the dirt. And now that 343 are taking a little bit more time to develop Halo Infinite, we are hoping, I think every Halo fan, whether or not they enjoyed MCC or Halo 5 or not, still wants the next Halo game to be a good Halo game. One that can bring people back to Halo. One that can showcase how good this franchise actually is. It's an awesome franchise. The gameplay is amazing. Even in 2019, the gameplay is amazing. Halo 3's gameplay for me, which released in 2007, 12 years later, is still great. Okay, and a lot of people feel this way. In fact, most people, I believe, feel this way. A lot of people don't want to see these enhanced mobility mechanics in Halo games, and I totally agree with them. As for complaining for the sake of complaining, or complaining to better 343, we have no idea, really. This guy's jumping to a conclusion over what actually will help 343 and what will guide their hand, over what won't and what they won't listen to. If I was 343, I'd listen to everything. all sorts of different criticism needs to be listened to. Why? Because sometimes, even if someone is salty, even if someone can be insulting in how they act, they may have a point. Now, it is harder to listen to, and you should conduct yourself with more decorum, which I'm trying to do. Look, I know this video title is controversial, but I'm still trying to break these people's points down and say that this is the kind of thing you're going to see from people that are more pro 343, or people that are more prone to forgiving 343. This is my favorite franchise, and it was run through the ringer, and it was put in absolute jeopardy of never existing anymore because of the decisions that were made by 343. So I think staying on top of 343 and staying on top of comments like this that the community will post is a way of making the game better and making the community better and making us more focused so that we can actually make changes. As we saw with EA and Battlefront, the community can actually change things. I thought Battlefront was... I never thought Battlefront could fail. After the first one's debacle, I never thought it could fail. A lot of people thought that Halo could never fail, especially with Master Chief Collection. All the Halo games in one, people thought that could never fail. So, you never know what can happen, guys. You really never know, and it just... It's really laughable at this stage that people are still having these conversations with each other. So this one I think we just covered in the last points, but I think this guy is a little bit salty. LOL! Halo players are never happy, are they? Well, that's not true. I was extremely happy throughout Halo 1, Halo 2, Halo 3, and even some of Halo Reach. And it all started going downhill with Halo 4. And we know that there was one major change that happened was a new caretaker, not a new owner, a new caretaker of the Halo franchise. So I believe in order to keep the franchise honest and keep the franchise what it was and what it was built to be by the long-term fans, that I think we should provide some criticism. So it's not that we're never happy. There are some things that I'm happy about. There are a lot of things, though, that I'm not happy about. So in order to keep the community honest and keep us focused on improving the game and getting the experience that all the fans can get behind, which does mean classic gameplay. I know I'm just saying that as an aside, but I think that they need to focus on some form of classic gameplay at launch for the community, including Forge and Big Team Battle and all these different types of playing the game. They do need to focus on these types of things, and that will make Halo players happy. So, Connor Gunn, Halo players can be happy. You just have to make Halo a Halo game, and then Halo players will be happy. It's pretty simple. Hasn't been done for a few years, and when it has been done, it's happened way too late, and it's happened at least 2 years into its life cycle, if not four for MCC. So that is something that would make Halo players happy. So on your point there, I am a little bit salty, to be honest, because Halo has not been made into the game that it could be, and I want it to be. So I will be happy when it's made into the game that it can be, if it's made into the game that it can be. On to the next point. So this guy here, Master Jazz, seems to think that we're all a hive mind, to which I said, if you're willing to disregard evidence, then you're 343 tards, seek help immediately. I left that a year ago, and after reading this comment and the rest of his replies, which are on my COD copying Halo video again, or Halo copying COD video, whichever way you wanted to see, I kind of argued both points there in that video. But yeah, he left this comment there about a year ago, so we're finally getting to it, Master Jazz. Pepper Angus. So I rolled my eyes so hard at the title, almost just click thumbs down and left, but I decided not to. Clearly you didn't, because you commented. Sprint etc. should not be removed. I'm fine with a classic playlist. Good. Good. I'm glad you're glad with a classic playlist, because I honestly don't think that they're going to remove Sprint for Halo Infinite. I think we're guaranteed to have Sprint in Halo Infinite, which kind of pains me to even say. They are not going to be removed. Yep. They should stick to their guns and keep improving like they have, as the multiplayer is pretty great. Oh my god, I think most of the community would argue against you on that one. You guys need to go find another game if you don't like the changes. Here's something that I don't like, alright? Don't you dare tell me to go find another fucking game, okay? Don't you dare tell me to play another game. Until 2014, when really the shit hit the fan with MCC, for 13 years I've been playing Halo and loving Halo. And yes, I didn't exactly like Halo 4, but I was willing to think that maybe they're going to do right with this time. They messed up their first game. I'll give them the benefit of the doubt. We can't just keep giving them chances. And yes, a lot of people like the current gameplay of Halo. Most people don't like the current gameplay of Halo, and that has been shown across YouTube. If you look on YouTube at some of the top videos on Halo, a lot of them are how 343 destroyed a franchise that was beloved by all. Okay, absolutely beloved by all. And tell me, go play another game if you don't like this game. I like Halo. I want Halo to be Halo. It has the potential to be itself, which made it a giant in the gaming industry. So for some little dude to come in to the comment section and so arrogantly say, just go play another game, just kind of shows that, yes, that's 343 tarded right there. That's saying, if you don't like the game that 343 has put out, then get the hell out. And that's no way of making and fostering a game community. And Halo already has a crazy good gaming community. As we've seen with Halo 3 being so popular in all the recent tournaments, people are flocking back. They're selling more passes for Halo 3 tournaments than they ever did for Halo 5 tournaments. And why is that? Because the gameplay was superior. The games that I grew up playing are better than the games that are released now. They're better than the games that some 13, 14, 15 year olds are exposed to now. I'm 27 years old. I have grown up playing better games than most of these little kids these days who come into the comment section and comment like this. It's stupid. So he says here, it's a dead horse by now. Halo 3.5 is not coming. Go play MCC or the Halo fan game. I think he means El Dorito, which was closed down by MicroDick. Because it posed a threat, because a lot of people were enjoying it, a lot of people were flocking onto the game. It was basically a free version of Halo 3. Yes, they did take assets from Halo Online, which was why it was DMCA'd, but come on, guys, like, this is ridiculous. This is absolutely ridiculous, saying go play a fan game if you want the classic Halo experience. Doesn't that just sound so wrong? You know, that a fan game can provide a better Halo experience than a AAA Halo release from a AAA developer, from Microsoft, as a publisher. Come on. This is ridiculous. This is why people like me make videos. This is like people like me make videos like this, breaking down these comments. Because as this guy says, he still ended up leaving a dislike, as it's just a common 343 hater spew. You guys are a hive mind. So, I don't think we're a hive mind. I don't think it's typical 343 hater spew. It's not hating. It's really constructively criticizing 343 to try and get them to make the right decisions for Halo Infinite. The community managers need to be on the ball with this kind of thing. We need a classic playlist. We need ways of playing the historical version of Halo. Because think about it. If loads of fans were built on that gameplay, they clearly enjoy that gameplay. There's a market for that gameplay. And to diverge the mechanics in a totally opposite direction is just illogical. It really is, and this comment is totally stupid. So this guy, I think, is going to take the cake in this video for the worst and stupidest comment, in my opinion. Let me know what you guys think about this comment down in the comments section below, and all of the comments for that matter. Okay, let's get to the next point. So this is going to be the last comment, but this guy here, the guy that pushes the pull door, and we can see why he does, because his comment is totally stupid. Don't speak as if you speak for every Halo fan. Halo 5's multiplayer was extremely... I can't finish that without laughing. Halo 5's multiplayer was extremely successful, with a lot of pros saying it's the best competitive Halo since Halo 2. If a pro player says that Halo 5's competitive multiplayer is better than Halo 2's competitive multiplayer, that pro is an idiot. And don't listen to that pro. I don't give... Here's something in the Halo community that needs to be understood. Just because you're a pro player doesn't mean that your opinion has more weight than the community's. Okay? Or even members of the communities. Okay? Just because you're a beast on the sticks doesn't mean that you know more about Halo and the direction that it should go in. A pro player has stakes in the game. They want to earn money playing the game. Okay? Look what happened with Halo 5. They had an entire pro team on to help guide the direction of the multiplayer. And look where that got to. Look where that got to. They spent months making that fucking breakout game type and no one played it. No one gave a crap about it. So just think of it like this, guys. Pro players should not speak for the majority of the community. Okay? Because none of us, the majority of the community, are never going to be pros. We just log on and play the game and we enjoy it. So if you cater to the more casual audience or the core audience of the game and not so much the pro players, then you're going to make a good game. Now, what made the old Halo games great for pro players and for regular players was it was so even, it was so balanced. The mechanics were, you could predict what was going to happen. There was enough there to make it enjoyable for casuals and enough there to make it competitively viable. So that's pretty much the end of this commentary. I had to end on that point because that is just supremely stupid, I think. And we can see why this guy pushes the pull door, because his head's not really in the right space. Just because someone has enjoyed the previous Halo games and enjoyed Halo 5 does not mean that their opinion has more weight because they enjoy all the Halo games than someone else who has criticism. We have criticisms, and I think we have valid points. These people have valid points as to why they enjoy it. I don't think anyone is arguing so much against that. We're just arguing our points because we're emotional about it. We enjoy the Halo games and we want to see Halo climb back. This comes from a place of love for the fans. Our criticisms, they really do. And until people start understanding that, videos like this one that you're watching are going to continue to be made and will always exist. Because we need to show these people that, yes, just because we disagree with all these points and we'll counter-argue you. Every time that you bring these points, we'll counter-argue. We want the game to be better just as much as you do. And listening to one side of the community and not the other is biased. And that's what happened with Halo 5. One community side was listened to, the other was not. And it was a backlash. And there was a lot of people that left the game and a lot of salty videos that were made against Halo 5 and both 343 and Microsoft. So if you think of it like that, the people that are spewing hate, as we saw in a previous comment on this video, are actually the people that are more willing and honest and able to put themselves out there and say what they believe needs to be said. And if, I think both sides of the coin trying to be truthful, but let's just tell our truths and let's let the community and let's let the developer decide which ones they want to listen to. If they don't want to listen to us, fine. But I think that there still is a market for people that want to hear this type of video and that agree with me, that mirror my thoughts. So if you don't agree, that's fine. Leave a comment down below. You can do whatever you want. You might appear in the next one of these videos if it's outrageous enough. So do your worst. Do your worst. I'm not afraid of it, guys. All right, thank you very much for watching this video. If you did enjoy this video, remember to rate, comment, and subscribe. Thank you so much, guys. I will see you in the next one. It feels good to be back and making these types of videos. And hopefully you enjoyed the intro. I love making those. So see you in the next one. Bye-bye.